Friends, today we talked about door locks. It's a universal door lock used in front-load washing machines. Often, when the door lock is damaged, we can't understand whether it's okay. So we will explain how you make a tester to check it and the use of the multimeter. Then we will tell you about the internal schematic and functions. Let's start the video, and I will tell you what is this. First of all, friends, we'll tell you where is the door lock. When we open the front load washing machine, we often see a hook pressed in the body to lock the door. We easily pull the gasket out. If you check by hand, here is a spring clip. Its spring is attached to the lower part of the door. The spring clamp will come out with its ring if you pull it outside. When the ring clamp has been out, you can easily take out the door gasket as well, but be careful if you pull out the door gasket from the machine body. Now push the door gasket backward, the door lock is here. Now we are opening the screws of the door lock with a screwdriver. When opening the second screw, hold up the door lock with your hand so that you never fall it down. Now you can see it comes out very quickly, and then you will see the wire connector. Disconnect the wire connector and take it out. Now, we will test it. Different brands use different techniques. For example, one brand makes various models and they keep some changes in every model. So that why also changes in door switches or they use another kind of door switch. I have some connections that are different from each other. When I explain the connection, you will be able to check it, but when I show you the tester, you will be able to test it better. You have to understand two switches and then start work. For example, when the door switch is not working, you want to change it and bring a new one or second hand. First, you understand the terminals. I have four switches, but I'll show you two switches. I will show you all of them. Now you can understand that I have easily kept all the door switches in one direction. I will show you the difference between each other if any kind of difference is available in the door switches terminal, so you don't worry about that difference. You should follow this method to work. See this door switch start, if you are with me, its terminal goes left to the right. The last terminal is not available. The second and third terminals are the same, but the fourth is different. This door switch has different terminals, starting from right to left. Unfortunately, the last L terminal of the left side is not available. It's a big difference, and if you don't understand this difference, then door locks will become faulty, and PCB will be defective if a short circuit goes through faulty connections. It's necessary to check the position of terminals, left to right or right to left. See, I hold two door locks, every company prints the number on this type of switch. These door locks are different, one is right to left, and the other, left to right. Each has three terminals, and the fourth one is empty. You have to read the numbers carefully on door locks. They are almost identical, with the difference between right and left being a big difference. You must remember this difference and see the numbers 1, 3, 2 and right to the left. Then, I will show you a second door switch from left to right. 1, 2, 3 are the same numbers on the second door switch, you have to remember them. What is 1, 3, 2? This door lock works like a switch and electrically without using any coils. It made by best mechanical method. Now I will show you the inside door lock and how it functions. Although eclectic pass-through, so we make a diagram. So its electric diagram is something like this. The door lock has a PTC sensor installed in it. So this is one of its electric points, then the second electric point is this one, so these points are its line and neutral. Then the door lock's third electric point has a switch installed mechanically in the door lock. When this switch point joins together, this point is attached in series. Now let me tell you the wiring connections of the washing machine door lock. That what point is connected with which point? The one number point is always at the top. The third number point is in the center. The two number point is on the bottom. The phase wire should be given at the first number point of the door lock. The neutral is always at the third number point. The second point is the common point of the door lock. When the switch points are attached in series, it passes electricity through the electronic board. When we close the door and start any function in the washing machine, the electricity passes through door switch terminals, then the point of the switch of the door lock is joined together. But how do they connect? Now I will open the door lock and show it to you mechanically. Now I will open the switch mechanically. You can see this is a mechanical device, and we can't see any electric thing installed. The design of the door switch is very efficient. The number 3 terminal is joint mechanically, and this point is pressing down from here. Now I will show you another side. Here is a switch through which the third terminal joins the second terminal. We made the connection and gave electricity to it. So observe it. As electricity has passed through it, the switch has turned on. So what is the reason? The reason is that a biometal strip becomes hot and joins and turns to bend. After turning the biometal strip, the switch becomes pressed. Now I open the door lock to show you what things are in it. So we pull out the spring and see it is a metal. Here is the PTC sensor under the metal. When the PTC sensor becomes hot, the biometal strip turns to bend and press the switching upward. See this point, which is the second terminal in the series. I will show you how it works in the washing machine when the door is closed. I showed you before when we put the pin inside this door lock. When the door lock is pressed in the lock, then we see the red point. What is the red point? In some cases, its color is different. I have another locked door that is open. When pressed, this is a thing that comes out from its position. When it comes out, the mechanism becomes moving and locked here. Now I will be testing it, then you better understand. Finally, I can explain to you how you make a tester. The material requirement is a few connectors or use of soldering, 2 switches, and 3 lights in a different color or the same colors as you like. These are 220 volt operated lights. Also, we need a fuse, and it would be best if you had a fuse that is 1 amp. Next, we need some wires with connectors. The last is the testing box. We had already prepared the board and cover plate and maintained its size. We made all the holes to save time. Now I will install all items on the cover plate. And we will return. We install all the things on the cover plate. It is backside and another front. See, here are 2 switches, 3 lights, and 1 fuse. Now we will make the wire connections, and also I will tell you how you will test it. First, we installed the main supply, and I prepared it with connectors. Now I will install the wire connections on the input terminal of the switch. And also, on one side already, we had soldered 2 wires on the fuse terminal to save video length time. We put the main supply's first point on the switch's first terminal. Now we connect the fuse on the second terminal of the switch. We put neutral wire on another side of the terminal. We attached the neutral wire with input and got output from the fuse. We are on the next level, connecting the red wire in the fuse, which is output. Next, we have to attach this wire to another switch. We also connect 1 point of light with a fuse. Now, we connect the red wire to the input of another switch. Now the connection has been completed. I have made another wire loop, and I have connected 1 side of the loop wire with the light, which will be connected with the neutral. The other side of the loop wire will be connected with the input of the second switch. And these connections are completed here. So now we are at the next level. We will need 3 wires, which I had already prepared in brown, white and blue colors. So I have attached thimbles with it. And put protective rubber on the top of the thimbles. Now I will tell you about the wire connections. We have another 2 lights, green and blue. So we join 2 points, one from green and red and the other from blue and white, and attached with brown wire. Now they have become common. This common wire goes to the main supply in the white switch. The next point is we have a blue wire, which we attach to another point of green light, becoming common. So now we connect it to the main supply in the neural terminal of the white switch, so the connection is complete. Now 1 white wire of blue light is left, so we attach it to another white wire directly. It has become common with protective cover. Now the board is ready for testing. However, before testing the door switch, I will tell you there is a modification on the board. I changed the blue light because it does not function properly. First of all, I will tell you about the function of the board. You should know about the electric point of positive and negative. Then, we have to mark the switch. After this, see what these 3 wires are. The brown wire is the line, blue is neutral as connections, and white is the testing point. We install these wires in the door lock with the same procedure I told you about. The brown wire is a line, so connect with one number terminal. The blue wire is neutral and connects with the three number terminal, and the white wire is connected with the two number terminal. Now the wire connections are complete, I will tell you about the system. When we give electricity to the board, the red switch is already on. So if the red light is on, it means electricity is present on board. At the moment, electricity is not available on the door lock switch. When we press the white switch, then electricity pass through and door lock. So if the yellow light is on, it means the door lock switch is okay. In case the yellow light is off, it means the door lock switch is faulty. How do we know if it's faulty or not? Normally, when the machine's door is locked, mechanisms become pressed. Now press the white switch on board, the mechanism becomes stuck at the point and cannot come out. On the other hand, when we press the mechanism, the yellow light turns on means the door lock switch is okay, not faulty. If we press the mechanism and the yellow light does not turn on, it is faulty mechanically and may be a fault in the PTC sensor or biometal strip. So now we turn off the white switch on the board, and the door lock will open in 2 or 3 minutes. So this is the testing method. This is for today's video. I will catch you up in the next one.